I suppose, in direct competition with yourself.
No.
But there is an element where your game might have been improved in the green shirt had you had Wes as a middleman between you and the strikers.
Crying out for it. Absolutely crying out for it. None more so than Euro 2012 when we were playing against Spain or Italy. When, especially against Spain, it was like you were in a nest of bees or wasps. There was that many players floating around you, and we're stuck in a four-man midfield, getting overrun, as per usual, against the better opposition. Whereas someone like Wes, I think it was his third cap, was my last cap, which was late November, November 2012 against Greece. Wes came on, I think it was half-time. I came on as a sub quite early because Glenn Whelan got injured, and straight away, that extra man, that bounce pass into midfield, the ability to find him in those little spaces, it just makes your life so much easier. It really does.
Even, so say, for example, so in that game, Whelan's off the pitch, you're on with Hoolahan, so even in the absence of Glenn Whelan, it's easier to play because you've got Wes there. It's nothing to do with, the protection of Whelan is essentially a moot point then.
Yeah, well, to get Wes in the team, he has to play as the out-and-out number 10. There's different ways, obviously, you can manipulate the midfield, whereas now we have, say, a midfield of one sitter and two leg-type ones in midfield, which works so well against Italy and the Euros. Whereas, I can't remember, it was James McCarthy, maybe, who started that game. I came on for Glenn, so it would be maybe myself and James McCarthy. I can't entirely remember. And Wes ahead of that. Mm. And Glenn Whelan, who is someone who gets a ridiculous amount of criticism, unwarranted, and again the other way. So in terms of the public clamour for Wes and putting him on a pedestal, and which I agree to a degree, I think he's a very talented player, but I don't just go along with it because
it's two ends of the spectrum, really, wasn't it?
Yeah. And Glenn Whelan, very different type of player. You can't play with three Wes Hoolahans in midfield. You need people like a Glenn Whelan, you need people like me and a team to let those players, those flair players. So for instance, could you have imagined a team back then of myself, Glenn, James, whoever it was in the two midfield positions, with Wes ahead of it, Damien Duff one side, Robbie Keane as the focal point. That forces you to play a certain way. You cannot play it direct because you have to find those players with quality in the final third of the pitch. So it changed the whole sway of a team. But obviously, it depends on what way your manager wants to set you up.
Yeah, it makes you think, just even about the recent campaign, and think about the potential of Arthur and McCarthy, maybe, or Myler in those two positions you mentioned there, with Hoolahan just ahead of them. I know Walters was missing for a long time from that, but he'd have McLean on one wing, whoever it may have been, Shane Long or Darren Murphy up front, and then whoever was fit on the right wing. Like, that certainly seemed to me to be a team that a lot of people were saying, this is the one we should be going with. And the only reason people were saying that was because they had Wes Hoolahan right there in that number 10 position, which I don't think there was any question was his best role, is his best role, and we're still going to see probably a couple of more unbelievable goals with Norwich before his career is out. And it is just a feeling of regret. It's like, I don't know why I'm
saying that. You say that, but I go back to some of the points I was making earlier in terms of his club career dictating how much of an opportunity he gets. He couldn't realistically be thinking he should be getting caps up until probably the age of 26, 27 maybe, in and around Blackpool, season-long loan start, but then he signed in a permanent. But it was mainly Norwich when he really catapulted himself. And it was his second season at Norwich, I think it was, where he scored a lot more goals and came to prominence.
So that's when they got promoted in the first season and then second season in the Premier League.
That
is when he comes into the public consciousness.
And then you're thinking, yeah, fair enough. And then it depends very much on the manager who's in charge. Obviously, the last two have been Mr. Trapattoni and Martin O'Neill. What system does he fit into it? Doesn't fit in under Giovanni Trapattoni. He was reluctant to play anything else but a 4-4-2, compact and quite direct.
Yeah.
Defensively orientated. Defence first, anything else was a bonus. Rely on the magic of Damien Duff, rely on the magic and goal scoring ability of Robbie Keane. That was it, really.
Yeah.
Under Martin, slightly different. Martin was willing to tweak tactics, shape of the team. So his opportunities were more. And he did. He got a lot more caps, obviously, and the majority of his caps on the Martin. He was the third most used player on the Martin's reign, wasn't he? But in terms of minutes played, I know you've already mentioned, he will be frustrated. But in his statement this morning, he's been very grateful. And he could have stayed on and probably got past 50 caps, used in that sparing fashion. But he feels content, I think.
Maybe. I do think with international football, the stakes are higher. So you don't have another game next week to make up the 3 points or whatever in whatever a 38-game season. So I think managers are less willing to take a risk, and with a team like Ireland, that hampers Wes Hoolahan's chances of starting any games. But the thing on his club career is what I think is, look at where his position. He wants to play in a club where he is the best player in the number 10 role. Mm. Or at this current moment, he's not maybe the best number 10 at Norwich, but he'll certainly play a lot around there. Yeah. And like just in terms of playing minutes. But say take peak Wes Hoolahan. He wants to play at number 10 and start for a number 10 for any club. And you're going down through the 20 best number 10s in English football before you get to the Championship. That's only 20 players, and club football is far, far superior to international football at the moment, particularly when it comes to the Premier League and the money involved. So I don't think the whole kind of, oh, he's not even starting for a Championship team stick was a fair thing to beat him.
No, I agree with that. And we've got a season ticket holder been on from Norwich City, Niall Murphy. Wes is the best player I ever watched. Absolute disgrace that he only got 43 caps. See him score at the Euros was a magical day. I was there at that stadium. Day off. Very good day. Very good night. But look, this is the affection that people have for Wes, and why there has been such a clamour, because he is very different to generally what we produce. I think we will see a difference in the next 10 to 15 years with the coaching that has gone on and is going on at underage in terms of the way they're produced. You know, Wes was very, very different. He was a magical player.
He could improvise.
And still is. Yeah. He was clever. He was cute. And I keep going back to that point about, and I've said this time and time again, he doesn't get the credit he deserves for what he does off the ball and how hard he works. He really doesn't. And that's probably something that annoys me a little bit. The fact that he has been seen as a luxury type player.
I wonder, is the off the ball work that some of the Ireland players do, is that really conducive to an Irish system? As in the high pressing, the winning the ball back, counter-attacking, as in it has been more of a sit deep, kind of wait and see, patient sort of game. And without the ball then, I wonder, does Wes Hoolahan, is he a little bit defunct?
Yeah, it is a conundrum, because he's probably one of the most clever and intelligent players I've played with in terms of the positions he picks up. And I keep going back to him in terms of that style. When you play with him, your whole team just changes. Because if I go back to when he first came in that Greece game in November 2012, we'd have had a midfield. I've already mentioned Glenn Whelan, James McCarthy. Can't remember who else was in the squad, maybe a Darren Gibson. You've got similar-ish type players, all with different attributes, but they're centre midfielders. Whereas Wes is just totally different. And even what's available now, or what's been available in the last couple of years, you've mentioned Harry Arthur, you've got Brady, Hendrick, all different players. We've got no one else like Wes Hoolahan, we really don't. And on that note, we've had another tweet in off Savo. Has anyone checked on Eamon Dunphy this morning to make sure he's okay? So we know Eamon's been a big fan of his. Look, I want to move on. Overall, been a great servant to Ireland. Special player. And he's held very, very dearly amongst Ireland fans.